If you're selling on Amazon on 2025, your keyword research strategy will make or break your business. Today I'm going to show you the best keyword research that I learned over the years. I'm going to show you the tips that I'm using in Nomadz with my own clients and with my own brands to master your keyword research and to absolutely crush it in Amazon. I'm going to show you the best tools in 2025 to do the keyword research, and I'm going to show you how to do it without any tools using only Amazon. So this video is good if you're only a beginner in Amazon and if you're already have a well-established brand. So let's start. Tool number one, the tool that made 2024 for me, and I know going to crush it in 2025, is DataDive. So if you are not aware of DataDive, this tool is massive for keyword research. It's doing, in my opinion, the best keyword research, and it's actually showing you the search volume and the relevancy based on the competition that you're putting in. So for this video, I decided to search a small niche in Amazon, cat heated bed. So cat bed is a big niche, cat heated bed is kind of a sub niche, and I want to show you how I'm conducting this keyword research for this niche. So we don't have any case study, we're just going to go step by step how to find the best keyword. So first of all, when you want to launch a product, or if you already have a product, you need to know your main keyword or keyword that is similar to the main. So for example, here, cat heated bed. When I'm searching it on Amazon, I'm seeing all the beds that have heated. So it means this keyword probably relevant. If you don't have DataDive, I highly suggest you to download it, so it will be easier to follow this video, or at least the first part of it. So I have the extension of DataDive, and when I'm clicking on open Divebox, it's similar if you used to use Helium 10 or Jungle Scout. It basically shows you all the product in this keyword with their ASINs, brand, price, relevancy, sales, etc. Okay, so we can see here all the product that we saw in the keyword. We can see the search volume for this keyword, the total revenue. We can see the organic, which is amazing. The sales, the relevancy. We can see that overall there's some products that increasing, that improving in BSR. And we can use this tab to decide which product we're going to conduct the keyword research on. So basically the idea of DataDive is to take our competitors, let's say 5 to 7, and the DataDive going to analyze all of their keywords, and they're going to show you the keyword based on the search volume and the relevancy. So what does relevancy mean? If for example this product is at the top page of cat heated bed, it will show that this keyword have high relevancy for this product. So basically DataDive showing you the average relevancy of all the competitors that you use. For example, if all of the competitors have a ranking on cat heated bed, probably cat heated bed is very very important keyword. But if only two of them had rank for cat heated bed, either you didn't put correct competitors or the keyword is not relevant. I like to do this manually because I think when you're doing it manually, you really can learn and study the product. So for example, here, this product is self-warming cat bed. So this is the top seller, 9K sales, but it's not heated bed. This one is a heated bed. I can put add to tray. This one also heated bed. I'm trying to find the product with higher volume in sales, but also high reviews. For example, this one, 10,000 reviews. Seems like it's probably one of the oldest products, so they have established keywords. So I'm going to click add to tray. This one, 600 sales, 33 sales, add to tray. This one, 800 units, $69, add to tray. We can see there's a lot of prices, and I want to take 5 to 7 bests. Now, another cool thing you can do in order to make sure you're taking the best ones in terms of sales, reviews, and also relevancy. So relevancy is you need to know your niche the best, but in order for us to take the best in units, we can actually click on one of the products, scroll down to product details, click on the category cat beds, and here we can see the best in the category. Obviously those are of the biggest niche, cat beds, and we're searching for the ones that are electric, that are heated. But we can scroll down and we can see, okay, this one we already added it to the tray, this one as well. So DataDive lets us do lots of things. If you want me to make a video solely about DataDive and its features, let me know in the comments. But for now I'm going to show you only the tool for searching keyword and tracking keywords in DataDive. So after we had, let's say, 5 to 7 products, we have 4. If the niche is super small, you can have 4, but just having more products probably will help. I will go back to the regular page and I will take another one. So this looks like also 1000 reviews, 200 sales. I will pick this one. Then when you're clicking on ASIN tray, you can click here, select, create new, put a name. I highly suggest putting the name of your brand and the main keyword you search with. So example, here it will be heated cat bed. I will search heated cat bed. And that's it. You click on dive and the tool will start to analyze it. Now, I already did the MKL myself. So MKL is the master keyword list. Before that, I decided to took also two self-heated ones just in case. And basically in this page, we can see each of our competitors, their strength. Strength meaning by the keyword, as they have more relevant keywords that are in the top first page or have the best keyword, they will put as very strong. It means they have more keywords that they are ranked on. This one weak, very weak, weak, very weak, another way very weak. It seems like there's a lot of opportunity here. If we will launch a product here and we will make sure to have all the keywords, probably we can crush it. But for me, the main thing is this one. So basically, DataDive gave us all the keywords, search terms 242, that are relevant to these products. We can see the search terms, we can see the search volume, we can see the relevancy, and here we can filter it out. Like I said, the relevancy is the average of all of our competitors. So for example, if one competitor is not ranking, the relevancy will go down. This is why it's so important to pick the right products, because if you're picking the right products and the relevancy is low, it means that those keywords are probably less relevant and it will save you lots of ad spend. So here we already have the main keyword. We can see the search volume. We can see that this niche is a bit small, but again, sometimes in small niches, you can actually make a lot of money. And it seems like to me, all the keywords are relevant. What I will also highly suggest to do is to filter those keywords by search and start to remove all the keywords that are not relevant. I already did most of it, but if we will go down, for example, pet heated bed, maybe it's less relevant. Maybe heat lamp for cats, it's not relevant. I probably don't want to spend on it. So I will start manually cleaning this list until I will have the best list. Another cool thing that DataDive showing us is the outliers, which is basically the biggest keyword that related to this niche. So we can see that cat bed is the biggest one. The relevancy is quite low because many of our products are not ranking here, because again, this is a sub niche. So I will highly suggest saving those keywords and either in Excel file, either you can keep them here in the MKL list, because later on we can actually do DataDive. And when we will do DataDive, we can track our own products. So just an example here, I'm going to show you how the rank radar looks like. So this is one of the brands that we manage. And basically we telling DataDive, okay, this is our own products and I want you to track all the keywords that we took from the MKL. And what DataDive is going to do, we're going to have all the keywords from the MKL. Again, we can filter them out and we will see the search volume, the relevancy as before, but we can also see for each day the rank. Again, number one means we are top position on this keyword. And this is massive because we can see in PPC which keyword we need to spend more on, which keyword we can actually start to reduce, which keyword we don't need to spend at all. So this is a really, really amazing tool. It's called the heated map. We can also see the overview, which is basically a graph of improvement or disimprovement. If we have more and more keywords that we are the top 50 or the top 10. Okay, so this is DataDive. Like I said, this is, in my opinion, the best tool and most accurate tool to do the keyword research. Now let's go to tool number two. And actually tool number two is Amazon itself. So in this part of the video, I'm going to show you how we can do keyword research in Amazon itself. We do have to have brand registry to use Amazon tools, but if we do have it, we can absolutely crush it without using any external tool. Again, I highly recommend to use the external tool to have all the keywords to see the bigger picture. But if you have only brand registry in Amazon, you can definitely do it without it. So again, I'm in the Amazon console and I will go to Product Opportunity Explorer and I will go to the brand analytics. When I'm in Product Opportunity Explorer, I will search our main keyword, cat heated bed. Now, a cool thing is that we can actually take from DataDive the keyword that we saw that have the highest relevancy, the best search volume, then drag it from DataDive because we already know this is the best keyword and put it in the Product Opportunity Explorer to get the most accurate results. And here we can see the top keyword. So heated cat bed, closable heated cat house, maybe this is a brand name, elevated dog bed replacement cover. So again, we can see that this niche is probably small. If the niche was higher, we would have seen much, much more keyword. But we can still see that this is the top search terms, heated cat bed, heated cat bed indoor, heated pet bed. So we already know the best keywords and the keyword that our competitors have the most clicks for. If I'm clicking on this keyword, we can see the search volume the last year. We can see our top competitors. So actually another cool thing we can do it first and then take those products that are best on this keyword and then do the data dive. And then the data dive is even more accurate. For example, this one, I think we already choose it in data dive. We can see the price, the range, the average fees. We can see that he's improving now. Either he's spending more or the niche is growing. I would assume that the niche is growing because it's winter time. But this is the cool thing. We can check it in Amazon. We will go to trend and we can see that the search volume is actually decreasing on the winter time. Another cool thing we can do is to go to search terms. And in search terms, Amazon giving us all the most accurate keyword with the search term, with the growth over the year, with the click share, and with the main top sellers on this niche. So again, we can use Data Dive, we can use the next tool that I'm going to show, but Amazon absolutely giving us everything, which is amazing. I really recommend to download it, put it in Excel near the Data Dive, so we will have kind of bigger perspective. What are the best keywords? If the keywords are in all of the tools, probably is the best keywords, the most relevant keyword. Another thing we can use is the brand analytics. We can go to the search analytics, search query performance. And if we already have this product live and this product already selling, Amazon will actually give you all the keywords that are relevant with the search volume, with their total count, brand share, lots and lots of metrics. And cool thing we can do, which is a bit advanced, we can determine our average click rate and conversion rate. Because for example, keyword number one, we see the impressions, we see the total impressions, and we see the total clicks. So if we divided them, we can actually get the average click rate. And we can do the same with the conversion rate because we have the sales for this keyword. You see the sales, total count. So actually we can get the average click rate, the average conversion rate from Amazon itself. Later on, we can see if we have higher conversion rate or click rate from the market. And if we does have it for specific keywords, it means that we can actually push it much harder. And it means that we have higher chance to be the top ranking on this keyword. And this is all by Amazon itself, which is insane. Now, the last tool that I want to show you, it's actually a tool that I learned about a few months ago. And this tool is insane. We can actually insert an ASIN of our competitors. And this tool will show us all the keyword that this product is ranking on and the distribution between the ad sales and organic. And this tool is ASIN Insights. Very simple tool. I think they have 30 days free, so you can actually test it. What I'm going to do, I'm going to go back to Product Opportunity Explorer, to the products. I'm going to take this product, which we know that is the highest in heated cat bed. Because again, we can see it here, and we're going to put this ASIN here, ASIN Insights. We're going to do research ASIN. And we can already see that this product has had its peak in January, and now the search is already going down, which is mean that probably the niche is decreasing or this product is decreasing. We need to check it. We did so in Product Opportunity Explorer that the search volume of this keyword is actually going down. So now we know why. We can see the distribution between organic and ads. So you can see how much they're spending on ads. And from my experience, it's fairly accurate. And now this is the coolest thing. We can see each keyword, their search frequency rank, their weekly search volume, and we can see what type of ads they're using. So for example, heated cat bed, they're using sponsored product, their organic rank is 35, sponsored rank is 2. It means that they are either the second highest bidder or Amazon thinks they have the highest chance to convert on it. We can see that they don't spend quite a lot of ads. Maybe it's a cheap product, maybe they have a lot of external traffic, but now we can see the data. And the coolest thing here is that we can actually export this file. And if you will export this file and you will put it next to Data Dive and Product Opportunity Explorer, you will find so much keywords that you wouldn't find in Data Dive or Product Opportunity Explorer, because this product is much more mature and probably have keywords that we didn't think about it. For example, heated pad for cats. Okay, it makes sense. Cat heated bed. But if it will start to go down, cat beds. So this product is on page 2 of cat beds. And cat beds, we saw that cat beds have 500,000 search volume. So probably this keyword also have good chance for us to convert to sales. So we need to save it and maybe later on put it in broad, low bid, because we know that it's not the most relevant, but we can get sales from here. We can see even dog heated beds. So this product actually getting sales from dogs. So maybe in the future we can create campaign by a theme of dogs just to make sure we getting some sales on low CPC there. And the list go on and on. Cat warming bed, I didn't think I see it. We can see that the search volume going down. I recommending to check the search volume of 250 and above, maybe even 450 and above, because below that probably you will cannibalize your sales. If you want me to talk more about cannibalization, let me know in the comments and I will create a video about it. But usually the best thing is to check search volume above 400. Again, if you have very, very niche thing, you can also check the lowest. But usually if you have good conversion, good CPC, you have best rank or good rank on the top keywords, you will have also good rank on the long tail keywords. But again, we can see so many pet heated bets for cats. So we can see so many keywords that we didn't see neither in Data Dive, neither opportunity sales, neither on Opportunity Explorer. So basically with these three tools, we can actually do the best keyword research possible. We're spying on our competitors with ASIN Insight. We're getting the best data from Amazon. We're getting the best data from Data Dive. We're combining everything to one set of big list of keywords. And then when we're going to do the campaigns, when we're going to do the listing optimization, we know that our listing is going to crush it. We know that we have the best keywords. We know what exactly our competition is ranking on, and we're going to crash it in Amazon. So this is the Amazon keyword guide for 2025. Like I said, this is exactly what I use with my clients. This is exactly what I'm doing with my own brand. And this is, in my opinion, the best strategy moving forward to 2025. If you like this video, let me know in the comments. If you want me to make more videos like this, please let me know and I will create more of this. Thank you so much.